We will start new topic, PN junction diode today. In this topic, we will start with open-circuited PN junction. One side of semiconductor is doped with acceptor impurities and another side of semiconductor is doped with donor impurities. This is the junction. The left side we have acceptor impurities and in the right side we have donor impurities. So the left side is P and right side is N-type. In P-type semiconductor we have negative immobile ion. With excess free holes. And in the right side, in N side, we have positive immobile ion with excess free electrons. This is negative immobile ion and this one is excess hole. These two are positive immobile ion and this one is excess free electron. Now, as we can see that in P side holes are in majority and in N side electrons are in majority. So there exist a concentration gradient for both electrons and holes. So holes will flow from higher density area to lower density area. Similarly, electrons will flow from N side to P side. And while crossing the junction, electron hole pair recombination takes place and the region near the junction is left with the immobile carriers only, and this will create a depletion region or space charge region near the junction because this region is depleted with mobile carrier or this region is full of immobile carriers. That's why it is called depletion region. So due to electron hole pair recombination, the region near the junction is full of immobile carriers, and that is called depletion region. This region is depletion region. And the width of depletion region is very small. It is of the order of micrometers. Now, here we are making an assumption that P side is uniformly doped with acceptor impurities and N side is uniformly doped with donor impurities. And this PN junction is abrupt junction. This junction is abrupt junction. So now we can draw the charge distribution in the space charge region. This is xn, width of space charge region in n side, and this is minus xp, width of space charge region in p side. At this point x is 0. So as the semiconductor is uniformly doped, in N side of depletion region, charge density is Q and D. And in P side of depletion region, charge density is minus Q Na. In N side of semiconductor, in N side of depletion region, we have positive immobile carriers, and in P side of depletion region, we have negative immobile carriers. And this width is W, depletion region width. Now, we can write the expression for volume charge density. That is rho v. This rho v is q and d from 0 to xn. And in minus q na, and it is minus q na from minus xp to 0. And the unit for volume charge density is coulomb per unit volume or coulomb per cubic meter. This is equation 1. Now we know the Poisson's equation. that is d square v by dx square is minus rho v by epsilon, where v is the potential. Now we can write the expression for electric field. In depletion region, now electric field is negative gradient of potential, so this is integration of minus of minus rho v by epsilon. So intensity of electric field is rho v by epsilon. Now for n side of depletion region, for n side of depletion region, E is 1 by epsilon, rho v is q and d dx plus some constant k1. So this E is q by q and d by epsilon x plus k1. K1 is constant. Now we can find out the value of K1, because at x equals to xn, at the edges of depletion region, intensity of electric field is zero. So substituting this in equation 3, q and d by epsilon xn plus k1 is 0. So k1 is minus q and d epsilon xn. So intensity of electric field is now q and d epsilon x minus xn, where x is between 0 and x1. Now for p side of depletion region, E is rho v by epsilon, integration of rho v by epsilon. Now substituting rho v, that is q na minus q na by epsilon plus some constant k2. So now the E is minus q na by epsilon x plus k2. Again, at the edges of depletion region, intensity of electric field is zero. So at x equals to minus xp is zero. Substituting this in equation 5, this will be now q na by epsilon xp plus k2 zero. So k2 is minus of q n a epsilon xp. So the expression for intensity of electric field is minus q n a by epsilon x plus xp. This is equation 6. So from equation 4 and 6 we can draw the intensity of electric field in depletion region. In the expression of electric field for n-type semiconductor, for n side, the slope is positive. This is basically equation of straight line with slope, with positive slope. And in the expression of electric field for p side of depletion region, slope is negative. So for P side, slope is negative. This is P side, and for N side, slope is positive. So the curve goes like this. Here slope is minus Q Na by epsilon. And intensity of electric field is 0 at xp, minus xp. And at the junction, intensity of electric field is maximum. For n side, slope is positive. And at x equals to xn, intensity of electric field is 0. And this positive slope is q and d by epsilon. The intensity of electric field curve should be continuous curve. That's why at x equals to 0 both the values are same. We can find out this value because at this point at x equals to 0 intensity of electric field is maximum. At x equals to 0, q minus q Na epsilon 0 plus xp is same as q Nd by epsilon 0 minus xm. So this will give Na xp that is equal to Nd xm. For P side, expression for E is Q Na by epsilon x plus xp. So Emax occurs at x equals to 0. So this Emax is q minus qna by epsilon xp. Similarly, for n side is q n d by epsilon x minus xn. So Emax is q n d xn with negative sign by epsilon, and these two values are same. By equating these two, Emax, we can obtain this relation. NAXP is same as NDXN. Now we can find out the expression for potential in the depletion region. Potential in depletion region. E is negative gradient of potential. So this V is integration of minus of E. So for P side of N side of semiconductor, in N side of depletion region, is Q and D by epsilon X plus xn. So this V is minus q n d by epsilon integration of x plus xn plus some constant, say k3. So this V is minus q n d by epsilon x plus xn whole square by 2 plus k3. Now at x equals to xn, this potential Vxn is denoted by Vn, and it is called electrostatic potential of n-type semiconductor. So Vn is, this is equation 7. Vn is minus q n d by epsilon this expression for intensity of electric field is this is xn minus xn square plus k3. So K3 is Vn. So electricity, so the expression for potential is now minus Q and E by 2 epsilon x minus xn square plus Vn. This is the expression for potential for N side of depletion region. Now for P side of depletion region. Intensity of electric field is Q minus Q Na epsilon x plus xp. So the potential is minus integration of minus Q Na by epsilon x plus xp plus K4. So this Vx is Q Na by epsilon x plus xp whole square by 2 plus K4. Now again at x equals to minus xp, this V of minus xp is Vp, and this Vp is electrostatic potential. Of P-type semiconductor. So this Vx, sorry, V of minus XP, that is VP, is Q Na epsilon minus XP plus XP whole square plus K4, which means K4 is VP. So the expression for Vx is better to write this minus Vp. So this will be minus Vp, and the expression for potential in P side of depletion region is Q Na by 2 epsilon x plus xp whole square minus Vp. This is equation 9. Now this curve is also the curve for potential is also a continuous curve. So the value, sorry. So the value of potential at x equals to 0 has to be same. So using equation 8 and 9. From equations 8 and 9, at x0 both the potentials has to be same. So Q Na by 2 epsilon xp square minus vp is minus q nd by 2 epsilon x n square plus vn. So vn plus vp is q na by 2 epsilon xp square plus q nd by 2 epsilon xn square. And this vn plus vp is v naught. This v naught is vn plus vp, and it is called barrier or built-in potential. So this V naught is Q by 2 epsilon Na plus XP square plus ND XN square. Now we can express this expression for built-in or barrier potential in terms of the width of depletion region by using the two equations NAXP equals to NDXN and XN plus XP is W. From these two equations, if we replace XP by W minus XN, then the XN in terms of W is NAW divided by NA plus ND. We will use this equation in equation 10. V naught is Q by 2 epsilon NAXP NA into XP is ND into XN taking this m dx in common, so we are left with xp plus xn, and this xp plus xn is w, or width of a space Chaudhryian, q by 2 epsilon and the xn w. And we have the expression for xn in terms of w, that is q by, so replacing xn here, so v naught is q by 2 epsilon and dw, xn is na w divided by na plus nd. So the expression for built-in potential is q by 2 epsilon na nd divided by na plus nd w square. So this W is 2 epsilon by Q V naught Na plus Nd divided by Na Nd root over. This is the expression for space charge region width in terms of built-in or barrier potential. Now this PN junction under zero bias will act as a capacitor, because the depletion region is full of immobile carriers, so it will act as a dielectric material. And P side and N side are the conductive regions. So the capacitance under zero bias is denoted by C naught, and it is epsilon A by W, where W is the width of depletion region. So replacing W in the expression for C naught, so C naught is now epsilon A by square root of 2 epsilon Q V naught Na plus Nd divided by Na Nd. So the junction capacitance under zero bias per unit area is now square root of Q epsilon by 2 Na Nd divided by Na plus Nd one by V naught. So we can say that this capacitance is proportional to V naught to the power minus 1 by 2.